Bess barely asked about the break-in. She seemed more focused on your fight with Dennis.
I'm on top of the suspect list. Or at least I would be if I was her.
Bess said I should call her if I found you. She believes you're dangerous. You were right back at the Basswood Jungle. I think we're on our own.
They'll try to arrest me now. We have to find Dickie. I can't let Joan down.
I'm sure Dickie's still there. He had no other place to go.
What are you two doing? The longer you run from the police, the worse it'll be when they catch up with you. Explain everything. Show them all you found. That's what a sane person does.
So, how should we handle finding Dickie?
You and I are gonna figure something out together. Don't worry. Or worry a little. Just not a ton.
Oh, trust me. I'm worried a ton. Just not a shit ton. We just need to be careful. And look out for each other.
This town has like 17 people in it. You've met the killer. I'm not saying you have to run and hide. Just be careful about the lion's den. You have options. That's enough!
What's enough?
Enough of a plan. I think we have enough of a plan.
Do we? I just get so angry that someone did this. Killed my friends, invaded my home. It's the worst feeling. Like part of my soul has been stolen. We need to find out who did this. I need to take back from them what they took. I need to find some small piece of feeling safe again. If that even makes any sense.
It's the knowing they might get away with it. The lie they made up being seen as true that just burns a hole right through me.
Yeah, you're right, I think. Then I think something else 10 seconds later.
Because you've got this. Easy. Look at you. So together. You got so drunk, you've forgotten anything that could have been remotely useful. Your friends are turning up dead. You're getting brained by burglars. And now we're riding straight into the back roads with no backup. You're afraid to let things go. Maybe she'd be lucky if she never saw you again.
Are you still with me?
Yeah. Yeah. So you're just gonna keep telling me off. Disregard my advice. Well, if you think you know better, Sam, no reason for me to linger. Enjoy your little investigation without me, Sam. Don't get us killed, okay?
Here. This is the cove.
Huh?
Get your head on straight. The cove. We're here.
Right. Right. Right.
Sam, you sure you want to keep going?
Not really, but it's not like I have much of a choice.
Sam, if you need to take a moment...
No, let's do this.
Who the hell are you?
Anna, what are you doing here?
Tyler, you look healthy.
You ain't the only one surprised I'm still alive. Who's the narc?
I'm Sam.
Was I talking to you?
This is Sam. He's a friend.
Yeah, lucky for him, or I'd have thrown his ass out already. So what are you two here for?
It's a long story.
We'd like to have a word with Dickie. Have you seen him?
What'd he do now? Look, just talk to Lynette. She makes the calls on her land.
Thank you. Really.
Yeah, I know.
Is he always like this?
He's pretty much the gatekeeper around here. Interviewed him last time I came by. I'm gonna talk to Lynette. She's kind of in charge.
I'll go see what I can find.
Okay, but be careful. People only end up here if they have nothing left to lose.
Looks like it was finished recently. Why a bear?
Watch it. The place is full of wood shavings.
Why do you have an open flame?
I don't remember asking for your opinion.
Fair enough.
I'm Kayla. What do you want?
You seem to enjoy wood sculptures.
You'd have to be an idiot not to. I'm creating something out of nothing and then turning it into something else. That's as close to real magic as we can get. So, you gonna tell me what you're here for?
I'm looking for a guy named Dickie.
Don't know where he is and don't care. He might be off with his stupid quad bike thing for all I know.
Quad bike thing?
Loud. Goes off-road, has four wheels. Makes you look like an asshole. Occasionally leaks gasoline and would have burned down the whole camp. Tyler didn't save his sorry ass with his fire extinguisher.
Well, I'll see you around.
I don't feel like you have to.
Dickie must have one of those off-road quads. He could still be here right now. I need more info to figure out where Dickie is.
Going well, it's just, I don't know, hard.
It doesn't get easier.
Oh, this is Sam. He's a friend.
We used to date.
That much is painfully obvious.
Is it?
Yeah, it kind of is.
I'm Lynette. What are you here for, Sam?
I read the article Anna wrote about you and this place.
Wait, you read it? When?
Nick's fishing shack.
Oh.
You never have any trouble with anyone. No one takes advantage.
As long as they can follow a few simple rules. Even if Dickie lives on the fringe of our community, he is one of us. All he wants is to be left alone. I would think you, of all people, would understand.
What led you to create this community?
I found there were souls in need of help after the mine closed. The world is a cruel place. We all need a touch of kindness in our lives.
You're definitely that, Lynette.
Thank you, my dear. But don't sell yourself short. Your article brought Kayla here, and even some generous donations have come in. Did you get your answer, Sam?
It'll do. I'll go now. Thanks for indulging me.
Naturally.
The clock's ticking. Cops will start looking for me soon. So Dickie lives here, but his place should be isolated from the others. I'm getting there. Just need a bit more info to close in on Dickie. Guess that explains how he ended up here. Makeshift ashtray. Probably keeps down on fire risks.
Sup? You a friend of Kayla's or something? Name's JR, I'm... Wait. You're that fucking reporter!
I was.
Fucking up everyone's lives. That's a real talent.
Former miner.
Get the fuck out of my face.
Just here to ask a couple of questions.
Do I look like a fucking tour guide? You keep bothering me, and I'm gonna stop being nice.
Thank you.
Tyler, right?
Jackass, right?
Some people call me that, yeah.
Huh. I'll bet.
How do you end up in a place like this?
None of your goddamn business.
How did you and Anna meet? You're not the type she normally hangs out with.
Maybe you're not the type she normally hangs out with. You ever consider that?
Trust me, I have. Just tell me where Dickie is and I'll leave.
Either that or you'll leave when I break your face. Look, Anna's a friend. She spent some time down here with us to do that interview thing. Told my story, did good by me, by us. And that guy that came after her, Nick, he's solid. Came down here 3 or 4 times. Taught me a great recipe for bass. But you're just some asshole. Dickie's one of ours. Don't think you're getting anywhere near his trailer. So beat it, before I break your knees.
So Dickie is in one of the trailers. That narrows down my search. I know enough to make an educated guess. Dickie's gotta be in one of these places. There's a quad, but Dickie's supposed to be in a trailer. I need to find out where Dickie's hiding. He's here somewhere. Dickie's unlikely to be here. No quad parked out front, and no one seems to be home. No quad, and it's right next to another mobile home. It's not here. Quad. Isolated. Someone lives here. That's where Dickie's hiding. Time to pay him a visit.
I only know you by reputation, and what I know I don't like. You don't get to just gallivant around here however you damn well please. So back the hell off, or I will fuck you up.
Hey, I don't want any trouble, just... sorry.
I should kick your ass out of principle.
Hey, man. This guy ain't worth it. Just forget him. But if he doesn't get the message soon, I'll help you work him over.
Got it. Got it. I'm gonna get past these two if I want to reach Dickie. I need to get them to look away from his trailer. Round Kayla's tent is the most efficient spot for a distraction. It's at the opposite end of the camp. They'd have their backs turned to me, but I still need a place to hide. They'd suspect me right away. Cabin stands right in the middle of the camp, far enough from everyone for them to not notice me. Close enough to reach Dickie before they come back. It'd be my best shot. I have a plan. All that remains is to figure out the details. It's deep enough. Could squeeze in here. Shovel, hose, bucket. Nothing useful, but there's enough room to hide in here. If they're in a panic, they might not see me hiding under this. Tyler set himself up nicely. I saw this picture in Ethan's bar, only intact. Guess I know who's been cut out. With all the flammable lacquer and varnish, this thing catching fire is sure to divert attention. It's out of the way, so no one should get hurt, but there will be lots of chaos. I just need to work out the exact details. It won't take long for the fire to reach those, and when it does, they'll go up in flames in a second. Need to account for that. If I lit the wood shavings, the varnish on the statue would catch fire. The statue will be collateral damage once the fire spreads. No other option. These shavings would be perfect kindling. I can get the fire going, but it won't do any good if they put it out right away. I need to check for ways they could put it out. The fire needs to burn long enough to distract, but small enough to be manageable. Don't want to see the whole place go up in flames. I saw a fire extinguisher in here earlier. If Tyler gets it, the fire might not burn long enough for me to reach Dickie. If I hid Tyler's keys, it'd take him longer to get the fire extinguisher from his trunk. No use. They won't let me anywhere near his trailer. I need a distraction. If I sabotage Lynette's old hose, she'll have to find something else to put the fire out with. I've got everything I need, but I won't be able to do it by myself. I need Anna's help. Hey, Anna, can I have a quick sidebar? Found him.
Where?
The goon squad won't let me near it.
Lynette isn't gonna be any better. They look after their own.
I can get there, but I'll need your help.
What exactly are you planning?
I need to create a distraction to get to Dickie. Setting the bear statue outside Kayla's tent on fire would work, but it's critical I wait for Anna to act first, or I won't have enough time. Then I can use a match to ignite the splinters and get the fire started. I'll have to get out of there before Lynette and Kayla can close in on me. After that, I'll hide in the cabin. Tyler and JR will leave to put the fire out. It'll give me a window of opportunity to run to Dickie's trailer unnoticed. That'll do it. No one will see me get to Dickie. I need to time everything carefully. I'll only get one shot. You'll have to be cautious. I need you to sabotage the water hose. Unscrew the cap where it attaches so there's no pressure.
Okay, but why?
Do you trust me?
Yes.
Then trust me. I've been looking for you. We need to talk.
Oh, no, look. I'm real sorry I clocked you and shit.
Clock me? You were the one that broke into Anna's house. You took something from Nick's computer. What was it? Where is it?
I didn't know what was gonna happen, man, I swear. I'm a nobody, all right? I'm just a guy trying to get by, that's all. I just wanna take care of my moms and live life, man. And I've been trying to find a way out all my life. I just agreed to talk to him for just like a quote or something. I didn't know he was gonna put so much together. He was gonna pin us to the wall. And now I'm as good as dead. You don't understand, man. I can't.
Stop rambling. What did you take?
His notes about his article. About the dealing and the drugs and names of dealers, and sellers, buyers, everything. I had to know I was gonna be next. You gotta believe me.
What'd you do with them? Where are they?
I don't have them, man. I left the stick at the dead drop up at Makeout Point. He'll pick it up soon, and then it's done. No proof, nothing.
Who's coming for it? Tell me who's coming for it.
My boss, Declan. His name is Declan.
Declan?
Yeah, the cop. You know him, everyone knows him. Oh man, I'm totally fucked now. When he hears I snitched again, I'm fucking done. But how was I supposed to know Nick was gonna stir shit up?
Are you saying he's involved in Nick's death? Tell me.
Come on! Just let me go! Please, I already told you everything! No, just let me go, all right? I really gotta leave town before he finds me! I'm begging you, man! Let me go! Let me go! Help! Anyone! Help me!
Shut up!
Hey, asswipe!
Should've known! Damn firebug!
I'm gonna kick the shit out of you!
Sam! Sam, we have to get out of here.
Shut up. Your ass ain't any better. You brought him here.
You've had this coming.
I can explain.
Oh, you'll explain, all right. Someone give me my rifle.
We're leaving.
God damn it! damn it, woman!
It doesn't make any sense. None of it does. Why would Declan do that? He was always a stand-up cop. Now he's a crime boss?
No time to think about it. Right now, we need to get to that dead drop. Nick probably gathered enough evidence to reveal what Declan was up to. Our word against his won't cut it. That stick is the only way we'll take him down.
Or maybe you could just stay out of this? Declan's trying to save his skin. If you go against him on that promontory, he'll be trapped in a corner. This isn't a game. This isn't a puzzle. And you're dealing with a man whose go-to solutions to problems has been to kill them away.
Remember what you promised Joe. Anna will not be safe where you're going. You can't bring Nick back, but you can still save yourself and Anna. Breathe. Focus. Think it through. Declan's already killed two people.
Sam, I know it's been a rough day, but you're freaking me out. Stop zoning out. We're just about there, and I need you to help me figure out our next steps.
Next steps? At a place where someone might put a bullet through your head. Nah, that's too dramatic. It'll probably be something... Stop it!
I'm not doing anything.
Other than trying to save your life. You're not thinking clearly.
What are you looking at?
You're focused on finding the facts and not focused on the very real dangers.
You need to focus on the road, not on whatever daydream you're lost in.
Just stop. You're the one that needs to stop.
Sam, you're going too fast. You need to stop.
Leave me alone.
Sam, stop it. Sam,
Sam,
stop!
There's a turret!
Stop!
Stop! Sam, stop! Stop! Stop the car! Sam, are you okay? You nearly got us killed.
I need a moment.
Take your moment, but make it quick. We're already at the promontory. We need to find that dead drop before Declan gets here.
We need to talk. Yes, Sam, it's time.
What's happening?
Sam, I can't.
Where are you going? Get back here.
I'm trying, but it's not working.
No!
Losing control of my own mind.
Where are you? Can you hear me? Can you even hear me?
This. Okay, do not freak out. You've been through this before. Ugh, I'm back in the same room again. Stick to the fundamentals. Breathe. Focus. You can make it out. It still keeps going. Feels like I'm trapped in a maze. Question is, where does it lead?
There you are. You and I need to talk. What? What's happening?
Remember the facts, Sam. That's how you'll get through this. I'm losing control of my own mind again. I'm almost making it a habit. Wonder what's in store for me now. Back to square one. was starting from the same position and looking at the same door. Always tackle a problem head on. Of course. There's no running away from it.
When my father lost his legs, nobody knew the mine wasn't following regulations.
Looking up everyone's lives, that's a real talent.
You think you know who Nick was? Mr. Perfect? Give me a break.
You have no idea. No one in this town does.
I don't need that right now. Just give me a break. I give up.
Cheers to Nick, a man that, unlike us, people actually like.
You know, Nick and I moved in together. Started to get serious.
They both deserve to be happy. Is that?
Your mother told me what happened. I know she's always pushing you to make friends.
Yeah.
Well, she's just afraid you'll end up alone. She doesn't want you to be unhappy.
Is she happy?
Not always. I'm not always happy either. Being happy isn't everything. I'd say it's more important to find out who you want to be than to be happy. Here, I brought you something.
It's so clear. I can see it all at once.
That's what gives it strength. It has nothing to hide. It can see itself for what it really is. And that lets it see everything. It's not a flaw. It's a gift. Like a superpower, you know? When the world is a storm, you stand calm at the center.
Now, I need to have a real talk with myself. Where are you?